Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel Simplifying UPSC with Ease with me Arpita Sharma, and today we are going to conduct lecture 2 on the current affairs decoded by me Arpita Sharma. We are going to create a repository, right, an accumulation of all the important current affairs for 2019 as well as 2020 UPSC examination. Right. So lecture 1 has been created. Lecture 2 we are uploading. Now this is a small announcement for all of you. As you all know that I am an educator on Unacademy. You can download the Unacademy learning app from the Play Store and you can follow me over there for daily decoding of the Hindu newspaper. Right. I decode the newspaper, the Hindu, for prelims and for mains for 2019 as well as 2020 UPSC aspirant. And also, if you want to purchase any of the courses by the top educators in UPSC category from Unacademy Plus, then you can get 10% discount by using this referral code Sharma20. If you use this referral code Sharma20 provided by me, then you will get 10% discount on any of the courses on Unacademy Plus. Let's start with the decoding. Animals in news. Black buck. It was in news. The black buck is also known as the Indian antelope. It is very important for prelims. It is also known as the Indian antelope, and it is an antelope which is found in India, Nepal and Pakistan. Remember the countries also. Now basically it is the sole extant member of the genus antelope. What do you mean by extant? Extant means someone which is still in existence. Okay. Now in India, hunting of the black buck, it is prohibited under Schedule 1 of Wildlife Protection Act of 1972. You have to remember under which schedule it has been prohibited. It has been prohibited under Schedule 1. The black buck is also listed as least concern on the IUCN red list. You have to remember the status of black buck on the IUCN red list for prelims. It is not extinct or not vulnerable. It is least concern. The binomial name of this animal is Antilope cervicapra. Alright. Now black buck is, you can say it is believed to be the second fastest animal after cheetah. So after cheetah, it is the second fastest animal. Punjab state animal is black buck, you have to remember. And black bucks also have religious importance in Hindu mythology and Bishnoi tribe of Rajasthan. That is why there are so many efforts in conserving and protecting the black buck. As you can see, it is least concern under the IUCN red list. Now comes another important news dealing with emerging dangerous cyberspace. Now cyberspace was also in news. There is a wide debate among the experts about the Trump's administration's decision to repeal Presidential Policy Directive 20. Repeal means, it means to cancel. So the next question comes, what is meant by the Presidential Policy Directive 20? It provides a framework for US cybersecurity by establishing principles and processes. And it also gives the US government the power to conduct surveillance through monitoring. So it was in news because Trump's administration has taken a decision to cancel, to reverse the Presidential Policy Directive 20, which was an Obama era cyber warfare policy. It was a cyber warfare policy through which the US government could monitor the cyberspace related activities, and then it could control the cyberspace related activities. Right. Now let us understand what is happening right now. Let us understand why it is important. What is it all about? PPD 20, that is Presidential Policy Directive 20. During the early years of his presidency, former President of US, Barack Obama, he signed this PPD 20, that is the Presidential Policy Directive 20. And it was not an open act, it was a very secretive act that only came into public notice when National Security Agency whistleblower Edward Snowden, he disclosed classified very secretive documents to the world in the year 2013. PPD 20, it deals with offensive cyber effects operations, which is also known as OCEO. They can also offer unique conventional technologies and capabilities to advance US national objectives around the world. However, such an operation required very rigorous levels of approval and government oversight. So therefore, basically PPD 20 has a very complex, you can say, approval procedure, right? And it also requires the approval and authorization of the president as well. Now, cyber weapon called Stuxnet. This is again important for your prelims. Years ago, the world witnessed the creation of the first major cyber weapon, which is known as Stuxnet. This is important for prelims. It is the very first, and it is the very first major cyber weapon related to cyberspace, Stuxnet. It is a very malicious computer worm, which was secretly loaded onto an unknown Iranian worker's USB flash drive. It is a self-replicating computer worm, whatever, in whatever hardware it is, in whatever system it replicates the data. It duplicates or replicates the data, right? And it spreads it like a cancer, infecting more than 15 Iranian industrial networks and eventually infected its primary target, Iran's nuclear facility at Natanz. That is very harmful for any country. Workers watched helplessly as centrifuges spun out of control. There was no trick, no strategy to counter this worm. It was spinning faster. The weapon was treated as significantly different from conventional weapons. President Obama himself had to personally authorize the attack under PPD 20. So from the above, all these, you know, instances, all these cases, it is very much evident, it is very much clear that the threat landscape is evolving in the cyberspace. In the cyberspace, the threat landscape, the platform is evolving. India is taking various steps towards strengthening the cybersecurity, but still India needs a very strengthened up war footing. We are still working on the digital India. We should work more on the cyber safety also. Government, private institution, along with educational institutions, they should work together to strengthen up the cybersecurity of our country. Now, this question can be asked in GS paper 3. What is cyberspace? How does it impact India's national economic and financial security? You can talk about the different cyber worms as well, like Stuxnet, right? Critically examine. In 250 words, you have to write your answer. Coming forward to the very much important news, Financial Action Task Force keeps Pakistan on the grey list and seeks action. It is important for GS paper 2 as well as 3. So the Financial Action Task Force, the Global Terror Monitor Organization, it issued a very strict statement to Pakistan to comply with an action plan on terror financing or face further action from the organization. 37-member group FATF decided not to remove Pakistan from the grey list. Pakistan has not been removed from the grey list. India is demanding to put Pakistan onto the black list, but this demand has not also been accepted. Grey listing continued despite Pakistan government's last-minute decision to ban Jamaat-ud-Dawah. FATF also criticized Pakistan for not showing a proper understanding of the terror financing risk which was posed by several terrorist organizations. Now, we should understand here what is FATF, and if Pakistan has been put onto the grey list, what does it mean for Pakistan? What effect will it have on Pakistan? So let us understand what is FATF. When we talk about FATF, it was set up in the year 1989. By Western G7 countries. Its headquarters is in Paris and it has 37 members. India also became the member of FATF in the year 2010. Saudi Arabia and Israel are also its members, and it also two regional organizations are its members, Gulf Cooperation Council and European Commission. Basically, this is an authority. It's an international watchdog on the issues of money laundering and financing of terrorism. Now the question comes, what is money laundering? Money laundering means disguising, hiding money earned from a crime. Crime means corruption, drug trafficking, fraud or tax evasion. Hiding that criminal money as money earned through legitimate sources. FATF works on peer-reviewing model. It can also publicly censor countries that do not follow its rules or violate its rules. Now Pakistan has been put onto the grey list. Now, Pakistan's banking channel could be adversely negatively affected as it is inevitably linked with the international financial system. And there will be the impact, negative impact on Pakistan's economy. Foreign financial institutions may carry out enhanced checking of transaction with Pakistan, right? So economically, Pakistan is going to get impacted. Now comes very important news, Olympic dream under threat. Now, India's future as the host of sporting events remain uncertain, unclear, following the decision taken by International Olympic Committee after India refused visa request from two Pakistani shooters. Now, basically, when it comes to sports, sports should be free from any hostility between the two countries, right? So, because India refused giving the visa to Pakistani shooters, International Olympic Committee is taking a decision. Basically, India's future as a host of sporting events becomes uncertain now. Denial of visa to Pakistani shooters has hit India's chances of hosting the Olympics because IOC is suspending all the meetings and talks with India. IOC, the International Olympic Committee, has made it very clear to the Indian Olympic Association, that is IOA, that all future interactions, all the future sporting events in India can be put on hold because of India's, action of denying the visa to Pakistani shooters. Because it shows discrimination on the part of India. India aspires to host 2026 Youth Olympics, the 2032 Summer Olympics and 2030 Asian Games also. Let us understand about IOC and IOA. When we talk about IOC, International Olympic Committee, it is a non-governmental sports organization. Where is its headquarters? It is in Switzerland. And it was created in 1894. This is important for prelims. Now, it is the governing body of the National Olympic Committee. And what is Indian Olympic Association? It is the body which is responsible for selecting athletes to represent India at the Olympic Games, Asian Games and Summer Olympic Games. It acts as an Indian or Commonwealth Games Association. It is responsible for selecting, for picking up the desired athletes, right? For picking up the desired athletes and representing them in the Commonwealth Games. Now, this is your mini test for today. Question number one, which of the following states have approved first black buck conservation reserve in India? Which of the statements given below related to asthenosphere are correct? And consider the following statements with regard to earthquake. So these are the three practice questions for all of you. You have to answer these questions in the comment section down below, right? In the comment section, post your answers regarding these three questions. If you practice these three questions on a daily basis, then you will make yourself very confident for prelims, right? This is a mini test. Solve this test. And if you like the class, if you like the lecture, then do not forget to like the video and to subscribe to the channel for notification for the upcoming videos, right? Thank you everyone. Have a wonderful day ahead.